The first bit of ambiguous evidence, these pictures. George Zimmerman, who says he killed Trayvon Martin in self-defense, told investigators Trayvon attacked him and slammed his head into the concrete. If that's true, are these wounds consistent with a head hitting pavement? Documents released Thursday show Zimmerman had abrasions to his forehead, bleeding and tenderness at his nose, and a small laceration to the back of his head. And if it was so bad, why didn't Zimmerman go to the hospital? Zimmerman declined to be transported to the hospital even after he told officers his head hurt and that he felt lightheaded. And there's this. If there was a prolonged struggle, would Zimmerman's DNA be on Trayvon Martin's hands? An analysis of scrapings from underneath the teenager's fingernails did not contain any of Zimmerman's DNA. But the autopsy done on Martin does show a cut, a quote, 1/4 by 1/8 inch small abrasion on the left fourth finger, an indication he might indeed have been punching Zimmerman. And new details also reveal the first neighbor to encounter Zimmerman after the shooting found him winded.
He was having a hard time because he looked like he just got his butt whooped. So he was a little bit more of a, not shock, but like just getting up type of thing.
There is also this unanswered question. As the two men fought, who was it neighbors heard yelling for help? In a 911 call, one police sergeant counted a man yelling, "Help or help me," 14 times in just 38 seconds. Listen to this 911 call. You can hear someone yelling in the background.
So you think he's yelling help?
The discovery documents show competing versions of the events. Of those who say they heard the struggle, some told police they thought they heard a young boy screaming for help. One witness, Witness 6, as he's called in the documents, thought it was the voice of a grown man.
There was a black man with a black hoodie on top of either a white guy, or now that I found out, I think it was a Hispanic guy with a red sweatshirt on the ground, yelling out help.
The FBI looked into this too, but their audio analysis was inconclusive, saying it couldn't determine whose voice it was due to the, quote, extreme emotional state of the person yelling, plus overlapping voices. The FBI said there was an insufficient voice quality on the recording. And what about that racial slur Zimmerman, a white Hispanic, allegedly used when describing Trayvon?
Back entrance.
FBI analysis released Thursday said they could not definitively identify the word Zimmerman used due to weak signal level and poor recording quality. That word is key to the racial discrimination argument. And legal experts say without definitive evidence he used a racial slur, the chances Zimmerman might be charged with a federal hate crime diminish. But an interview, which is also part of the discovery, with one of Zimmerman's former co-workers says something else. The man, who is Middle Eastern, said Zimmerman is a racist and a bully.
I was portrayed like the, I don't know if you ever watched comedy, this guy is called Ahmed the Terrorist.
No.
Okay, so it's this little guy, he's got this weird voice and some, that was me in the story. So the story turned my accent to, no, I kill you.
Okay.
And he kept going and going and going.
And finally, the question of drugs in Trayvon Martin's system. In his 911 call just before the shooting, Zimmerman indicated the teenager looked like he was on drugs or something. But even though we now know Trayvon's blood had THC in it, the active ingredient in marijuana, that may not mean he was high. One toxicologist cautioned THC can linger in a person's system for days, even spike after death. And HLN's Dr. Drew Pinsky warned, marijuana typically does not make someone more aggressive. With all the new details released this week, you'd think we'd be closer to learning the truth about what happened. But really, the one thing we know for sure is that a single gunshot fired straight into the chest of Trayvon Martin killed him. Randi Kaye, CNN, Atlanta.
One note, in a story published in today's Orlando Sentinel, the witness described as Witness 6, who said he heard it was Zimmerman yelling for help, later told Florida law enforcement he wasn't so sure who it was.